Good afternoon, traders. This is Tony D with a special update on the market. This Friday afternoon, we're seeing the US dollar coming under tremendous selling pressure. Looking at the dollar index breaking down now to fresh multi-year lows underneath those previous lows from January. We are at 88.18 as we come to air here. Now, obviously, US dollar is losing ground against everything. In terms of the main movers that we have running at the moment, the Aussie dollar is getting back towards that 80 level. Gold is threatening to get past 1360. 1368, remember, is a key level here. Looking back on the weeklies, some big resistance coming up. Pound is back above 140, all the way at 141. The euro is testing all fresh highs in the cycle. So these recovery highs in the euro currently are being tested as we speak. Let's look at the highs from last week to double check where we're at. Actually fresh highs as we go to air. It's broken above the 124.40, 125.40 level. Now open skies a little bit to the top side now. Really hard to see where the market can find support. If you're seeing where most of the selling is coming through in Asia, it's actually coming through on the dollar yen. So dollar yen's broken underneath 106. 105, remember, is the Trump levels. That's where the market bounced from, the initial rally all the way up to 115, 118 when Trump got in. Now we're coming back down. We are looking getting more and more vocal opposition and jawboning from the Japanese each day. Still, most analysts don't think that they would actually intervene while the pair is above 100. So it would require just market to settle down in terms of the speed at which it's selling. But definitely if it gets below 100, you can be a little bit more concerned about Japanese intervention into their currency. In terms of the yen crosses, so you can look at the dollar yen here. This was confirmed actually yesterday by the Japanese finance minister that they weren't looking to intervene just yet. And if you look at some of the crosses though, so you can see here on the euro yen, it is pulling back a little bit, but because the yen, the euro is so strong, then some of those losses are mitigated. Same with the pound yen. Pound yen is underneath 150, but not moving in an aggressive fashion. It's not the same as a risk off sort of selling where you would see pound yen and euro yen move more quickly to the downside. And the uptrends are still holding in both of these. So it is the mostly to do with the US dollar weakness that you are seeing this selling coming through. In terms of dollar index, looking here back in time, you have to go back to January, the US dollar rally that happened in 2014 as the US was exiting its QE. We see here that the next major levels are down towards the 85. So we've still got a significant amount of room here. That would put dollar yen at 100, euro at 130, and pound closer to 150 in the current market. So something to keep an eye on here as the US selling continues. Now this is happening at the same time that US inflation is picking up and you are seeing chances of the Fed raising in March increasing and yields in the 10-year approaching that 3% level. So there's not much helping the US dollar, even things which should in theory be helping the US dollar, they're not. This is a really dangerous combination, and you have to be always on the alert that if the price action is king, if there's selling going on, that's the direction the market wants to go, and it can continue much longer than you can fight the market. So if you want to have a question about what's going on in the market, you want to call us and look at how do I best express this, which pairs have still got catch up to play. Aussie dollar is still well underneath its 81 levels that it was at 2 weeks ago. Give us a call on 1-800-176-935 in Australia. If you're in Singapore, you can see the contact numbers below as well for the free call from Singapore. That is 315-83201. If you're not a member of the Easy Markets dealing room, you can join up on the link below.